Greetings there, it's Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the CanXida, that's with an X, CanXida range of dietary supplements. Thanks for checking out my video. Today we're going to talk about the causes of gut dysbiosis. You may have seen my video on what is gut dysbiosis, so now we're going to actually drill down into some of the reasons why people develop this condition that's so common in the Western world. I can safely say that well over half, if not three quarters of my patients today have some form of gut dysbiosis. So what causes this condition? What makes us to develop symptoms like bloating and gas and farting and burping and, you know, needing to take Rolaids or these proton pump inhibitor drugs to soothe this sort of burning tummy, stuff to take us from, you know, feeling bad in the gut, stuff to, you know, stop us from having constipation. All these sorts of things are often linked up with gut dysbiosis. So let's just go over a couple of different reasons why this condition can come about. What causes it? All right. Pharmaceutical drugs is a really big one. There are many different classes of pharmaceutical drugs that can cause gut dysbiosis. In fact, I always go as far as to say most drugs to some degree cause gut dysbiosis. If we look at some of the most commonly prescribed pharmaceutical medications today, nearly all of them are implicated in causing a disordered gut flora leading to gut dysbiosis. Proton pump inhibitor drugs. If we look at some drugs like Nexium, $6.2 billion US sales in 2014. That's a phenomenal amount of money spent. 9.4 billion US in total last year on drugs to stop reflux, heartburn, and GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease. How stupid is that? Why would you take a drug to stop acidity in the stomach? It's a dumb thing to do. We need good levels of hydrochloric acid to break down proteins, you know, fats and carbs and things like that. If we break food down properly, we're going to be able to digest it and absorb it and excrete the waste properly. If we're going to screw up our stomach with taking drugs to stop heartburn, we're stupid enough to look at the cause. You know, we're going to get a lot of problems as a result. So if you're a person watching this who's taking some kind of a pill or liquid or something like that to stop heartburn, try and find out what the cause of this heartburn is. It makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? Because if not, you're going to get a lot of problems downstream, you know, things occurring further down. If you can't break protein down properly, you're going to get putrefaction further down here, which is going to cause bloating and gas, pain, headaches, tiredness, aching everywhere. So it's not a good idea to do that at all, right? So PPIs or these sorts of drugs like Nexium are not good. They're certainly linked up with this condition called dysbiosis. Antibiotics are a very, very powerful drug that are one of the main drugs that cause gut dysbiosis because they're non-selective and they kill lots of beneficial bacteria as well as pathogenic bacteria. There are two ways how antibiotics work. They can rupture the beta-lactam's ring or the cell wall of the membrane of bacteria, allowing your immune system to get in there, or they can disrupt protein synthesis, or they interfere with what we call ribosomes in the bacterial cell, stopping the cell from actually forming. So, and you don't have to be a rocket scientist to work out if you're going to mess around with cells like this at that kind of level, you're also going to mess around with a lot of beneficial bacteria as well. And you're going to promote the production of a lot of yeast in the body and other kinds of bugs like Clostridium. You're going to encourage blastocystis and other parasites in your gut. So taking antibiotics for different conditions, you're on a course basically for disaster down the track. Taking them routinely is just crazy. It's going to lead to all sorts of diseases. You know, there are many other pharmaceuticals implicated with dysbiosis. I haven't got time in this video to cover all of them. Another key one that I would see would be NSAIDs or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Ibuprofen or Advil, paracetamol, okay, what's another one there? Aspirin, diclofenac. All these drugs are not steroidal, so they're not really steroidal based, but they ruin your gut. They cause dysbiosis. They destroy gastric health. They switch off pain, but at a huge cost to you. So, you know, again, why would you want to take these drugs long term? Because you're undermining your health. So if you take pharmaceuticals routinely, you will get gut dysbiosis. There's got to be another way. Talk to your healthcare professional what other ways you can, you know, you can look at. Stress. Stress has got an incredible way of causing gut dysbiosis long term. And there are several mechanisms by which stress operates to achieve this. One key thing that happens in the alarm phase or the acute phase of stress is it starts to reduce the blood supply to the digestive organs, favoring the blood to go to the larger muscles so you can run away from dinosaurs or the boss or your mother-in-law or, you know, whatever threat is hanging over your head. Stress is another ability at the different stages of the stress cycle to actually reduce the output of digestive enzymes, to inhibit peristalsis or the movement of feces through the digestive system. So it increases the likelihood of constipation, it increases the likelihood of bloating and gas. All of these things occur because of stress. Not chewing food properly and eating it too quick is a key thing I see in my clinic. If you're sitting there with your mobile phone liking someone on Facebook while you're eating a burger, you're going to get dysbiosis, all right? Get rid of these bloody electronic devices out of your life when you're eating food. Don't associate eating and technology. It's a big mistake that a lot of people are making today, okay? Chewing food properly, taking your time to eat food, slowing down. Do what your grandparents did. Spend time eating, not looking at Twitter or Facebook or junk like this. So I haven't got time again in this video to go over a lot of the ramifications and flow-on effects of stress, but needless to say, if you've got stress, you'll get dysbiosis. Diet. Well, this could be a half an hour video in its own right. There are multiple ways that diet increases your likelihood of dysbiosis. A lot of people today eat a highly processed diet. In fact, statistics show that people in England, for example, up to 30% of people don't even eat fruit or vegetables anymore. It's incredible. People eat so many different kinds of processed foods in their diet now in America, Australia, New Zealand. I've got patients now in about 40 countries on Skype and FaceTime, and it's incredible how many people now all around the world in different countries are just eating a highly processed diet. The patients I've got, however, that are older, you know, that were grown up more with mom and dad cooking food, proper food, you know, that come from backgrounds of cultivating vegetables and fruits and chickens and bees and things like that, which is my background, which is why that's the kind of lifestyle I like to lead. But those people tend to have better quality diets, which, you know, lead to a lesser likelihood of dysbiosis. The fresher the diet, the cleaner and greener the diet, the cleaner and greener the gut. Okay, if you base your diet around Diet Coke and burgers, you're going to have bad dysbiosis. So I encourage you to eat a good, healthy food, to avoid soda drinks. I believe alcohol is not really good a part of health, but if you want to drink alcohol, that's up to you. But I don't see it playing much role in human health. So sugars, yeasty foods, processed foods, refined carbohydrates in particular, they're going to cause dysbiosis. So those are three core things that are going to increase your likelihood of dysbiosis: pharmaceutical drugs, stress, and the kind of food you eat. Have a think about those things. Thanks for tuning into my video today.